People often wonder what's the primary reason why we have this increase in hate groups, or what seems to be going on. You know, we didn't have Obama, and not everything was okay. But it's not. The shifting demographics are the primary driver of the increase in hate group and hate group activity. In 1970, around the founding of the Southern Poverty Law Center, these are nationwide statistics, look like this, about 83% white, 17% people of color. And that is really like how the U.S. likes its diversity. Today, it's not like that at all. And it's really been a dramatic increase in, you know, just a few decades. Which, I am originally from California. We started experiencing these demographic shifts decade and a half ago. And it was hard there, too, on the most diverse place, you know, in the country. It was hard there, too, and it was ugly. And it will continue to be hard and ugly as we navigate this as a nation. So 66% white, 34% people of color begins to look like signs in different languages, hearing different languages, going back to your old neighborhood, things looking different, and you feeling like, oh my God, what happened? And then add on to that it's now part of the popular discourse that whites will no longer be in a numerical majority by 2050 or 2040. Have you heard that? See, everybody knows that, including the white supremacists. So they mistakenly believe that they can push back against that. And not just them. People thought this, you know, in the 80s when people were talking about immigration and we weren't able to come up with a comprehensive, comprehensive immigration reform bill. And it was because people thought that they saw the shifting demographics happening, thinking that if you tamp down on or limit entirely immigration, that you could change the demographics, and you can't. These are some things that have been planned for a while. So that's what it looks like around 2040, 2050, by 2050 for sure, but probably around 2043 or so.